creation awaits with eager expectation the revelation of the children of God. For creation was made subject to futility, not of its own accord, but because of the one who subjected it, in hope that creation itself would be set free from slavery and corruption, and share in the glorious freedom of the children of God. We know that all creation is groaning in labor pains, even until now. And not only that, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, we also groan within ourselves as we wait for adoption, the redemption of our bodies. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gave most of his teaching about the kingdom in parables. some seed always fails, and that some seed produces a good crop. What did Jesus mean by the parable of the sower? Well, Jesus was metaphorically sowing seed when teaching about the kingdom of God. Some people took his message to heart and then produced fruit from it. Others didn't take his message to heart at all and produced no fruit. Or they took his message to heart for a while and then gave up, so produced only a little fruit. It even happened to his disciples. Judas betrayed Jesus, and then we know he took his life. We would expect better from someone who had been personally taught by Jesus for 3 years and had shared Jesus' company. Now, all of the seed that Jesus sowed bore fruit, as it should have, or as we would expect. The same could happen in a family. One family comes to mind, the Barbaro family in Northern Italy. Carlo, whom we shall call Charles, became St. Charles Barbaro. He became a bishop, and while his twin brother Antonio became the head of crime in Northern Italy, even hiring killers. So why do some produce fruit for the kingdom and others apparently not? It always depends on whether we take Jesus and his message seriously. What is this fruit anyhow? Well, in Galatians 5, verse 22, Paul says that the fruits of the Spirit are love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, trustfulness, gentleness, and self-control. These are the fruits of the Spirit that we learn before our confirmation. Think of how beautiful our world would be if we all produced these fruits 100% of the time. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, trustfulness, gentleness, and self-control. You would have heaven on earth, wouldn't we? Jesus had a plan for our world, that we would form a new society where these fruits would be practiced by everyone. A new society which would be the most beautiful society in which to live and to be a part of. That society, of course, has not yet come into existence because none of us has yet produced those fruits 100% of the time. I just wondered what the percentage really is. Jesus gives reasons why. Some people allow the devil to take the word from their heart. These are the people who receive the seed on the edge of the path. They hear the word of God but don't believe its promises. They have heard the teaching of Jesus but don't take it seriously. They are the people who forget the meaning of life, who live as if God doesn't exist. People who forget that in this life we are only passing through. In Ephesians 1, verse 18, we read a prayer which goes like this. May the Father enlighten the eyes of your mind so that you can see what hope His call holds for you, what rich glories He has promised the saints will inherit. End quote. You know, if we forget what hope God calls us, holds for us, or what rich glories God has promised us, then we will not produce fruit. We will like the seed sown on the edge of the path. I have read two neighbors who quarreled and didn't speak for 30 years, and now they are buried only 30 feet apart in the same cemetery. It's an example of forgetting the hope God calls for us, as well as the glories He has promised the saints. As 1 letter of John wrote, think of the love that the Father has lavished on us by letting us be called children of God. That is indeed what we are. You know, if we don't believe with all our hearts that we are really children of God since we were baptized, then we will not produce the fruits of love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, truthfulness, gentleness, and self-control. In South America, it is apparently common for healings to take place during the celebration of Holy Mass. It's a rarity here. Perhaps it's because we don't believe the promises of God. It's because we are like seed sown on the edge of the path and allow the devil to carry off the word within our hearts that was sown. Second group who do not produce 100% fruit are those who fall away when some trial comes or some persecution. These people are like the seed sown on patches of rock. They spring up straight away, but have no root and give up following Jesus when it gets tough. When the culture of the world is different from the new society Jesus wants to found, they are afraid to take their stand for Jesus. And so, no fruit is produced. The third group Jesus lists are those who allow the worries of the world or lure riches to choke his message in them. They have forgotten that hearses don't pull trailers after them with a deceased possessions. These people are like the seed that fell among thorns, and the thorns that choke Jesus' message are the worries of the world and lure riches. Fourth group our Lord Jesus lists are those who produce fruit from his message. They are the ones who receive the seed in rich soil and yield a harvest at 100 or 60 or 30-fold. They are the ones who allow the eyes of their mind to be enlightened so they can see what hope God's call holds for them or held for them. And then what rich glories the saints are promised to inherit. May God the Father enlighten the eyes of our mind so that we can see what hope his call holds for us, what rich glories he has promised the saints will inherit, so that we may receive the word of God in rich soil and yield a harvest now 100 or 60 or 34. That harvest of love, of joy, of peace, of patience, kindness, goodness, truthfulness, gentleness and self-control. Today we have a couple here today who is celebrating their 50th wedding anniversary, John and Donna Berry. This in itself, 50 years, is a blessing, isn't it, that God has given them, along with their children, as the fruit of their married love, their marriage. Only God knows how much more fruit they and their children will receive and give back in thanksgiving to Almighty God. Please come forward now for your blessing. We pray, Lord God and Creator, we bless and praise your name. In the beginning you made man and woman, so that they might enter the union of life and love. You likewise bless the union of John and Donna, so that they might reflect the union of Christ with his church. Look with kindness on them today, amid the joys and struggles of their life. You have preserved the union between them. Renew now their marriage covenant, increase your love within them, and strengthen their bond of peace, so that surrounded by their children, they may always rejoice in the gift of your blessing. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed be God, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. proceeds from the Father and the Son, but with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets.
I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism
for the forgiveness of sins,
and the hope of the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come.
Amen.
We can offer our prayers and our petitions to our Heavenly Father.
For Pope Francis, that he may help and encourage us to be well prepared to hear and act on the Holy Word of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Bishop-elect Brzezinski and all bishops, that through their leadership, good fruit may increase in each diocese, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our parish family of St. Barnabas, that we may all realize the importance of spiritual preparation before the beginning of Holy Mass. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Jesus, the source of all we have and are, be loved and served more through all we say and do. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Supreme Court, that they will uphold the Constitution and defend what it proclaims. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the sick and suffering in our parish, and all those most in need of our prayers and support at this time, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our parish may continue to grow through new members and endeavors, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the protection of the St. Louis statue, and all who are attending the praying of the Holy Rosary, that peace and religious freedom may reign, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own personal needs and intentions that reside in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For together with your servant Francis Erpel and Robert Apostolic Ministry, and all those who hold to the truth and are Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember your service. And all your dear, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you the sacrifice of praise that we offer for themselves and all we do to them, for the redemption of their souls, and hope, health, and well-being, and paying our homage to the eternal God, living and true. In those whose memory we venerate especially, the glorious Ever Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, and James and John and Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, and Simon, Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Gregatus, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysostomus, John and Paul, Constantinian, and all your sins. We ask that through the merits and prayers of all things, we be defended by your protecting power. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that every whole family, order our days in your peace, command we be delivered from eternal damnation and count on the flock of which you have chosen. Please, O God, we pray, bless us and improve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritually acceptable so that it become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord, Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread and his cold, with trembling hands, with eyes raised to heaven. To you, O God, as our Father, give me thanks. He said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, and said, take this. All of you need to for this is my body, which will be given up for you.
God, rebuke, we humbly pray.
And you, thou, Prince of heavenly hosts, by the divine power of God, cast in hell Satan and all evil spirits,
who prowl about the world seeking ruins of souls. Amen.